Hey everybody, and welcome back to Deadwood Logging. We have been processing and we have caught up with the cutter. We got a bunch of logs on the ground, so we're gonna go out here and get us a log truck or a forwarder or something, and we're gonna start hauling them out here to the mill. I believe I'll haul them on this forwarder. We just got a short distance to go. We'll see how it does with them. They're a little bit longer than we normally haul. Us being so close though, I think this probably worked all right. We'll find out here in a minute. These logs are really too long for it. We can get them on it though. We can tie them down. That's probably enough on that load. I got about as much hanging off as I do on. That shouldn't matter though, maybe. As long as we keep our front end on the ground, I think we'll be okay. I think I'm gonna back in here and do like I done before, just fill the bunks up. Then we'll just fill the area up and we'll put them all in at one time. See how this worked. Actually worked out pretty good. Let me switch my loading side to the left and we'll pick up that one that we kind of missed a while ago. Now we'll go back to the right side and finish loading. I think we can get a few more on. We got another pretty good load. Yeah, I think this forwarder is probably made for 6 meter logs, maybe. And we're cutting them 9, so. Since we're not selling them, I think 9 is probably about the best for us. I think you actually get more if you're selling them, if your log's like a 6 or an 8 meter, I believe. If they fall over on the other side of the bunk, that's okay too, because it's still in the zone. It might be faster to haul them with a log truck, but I think this is working pretty good. It says we got 19 logs and 15 tons, and that's pretty heavy logs. That's gonna look good when we get all of that cut. Just gonna take a while to do it. Running about 15 ton to a load on average, which every two loads on this would be one load on the log trailer. I think by the time we get the trailer out there and turned around and out here and backed in and all that, we can haul probably about as fast with this. I don't think our hour meter is working exactly correctly on this either, because We've had this little feller since the start. Used it quite a bit, I thought. Got a big load this time. I hope we have enough to fill the sawmill completely full, but I don't know whether we'll make it or not. I think we still lack quite a bit, I think. All right, I'm just gonna start stacking them here beside the bunks now. I really like these auto load on the logs. It makes it just so much easier. Y'all let me know in the comments if y'all use auto load. It's a PC only thing, but it's really nice. I've not seen one of these forwarders any bigger than this one. I guess I make them this size so they can get around through the woods pretty good. We're going to have to take one of those chip trailers around to the back of the sawmill as well, because they're almost full of chips again. I don't know how many loads we had processed up, but it was, I think, a pretty good pile of them. I'd say we had at least 200 trees. Says 16 ton this time. I'm gonna stop and grab a chip trailer and take it around to the back so we'll be sure we keep them going. We'll just clean out what they got in there. It won't fill the trailer, I don't think. $229,000. This trailer holds 350,000 liters, so we still have a good bit of room. We may just leave it sitting here. That's all they got. Yeah, I think I will just leave the truck and trailer and all here. Well, it looks a lot different when you get all that undergrowth cut out. No small trees. We're gonna get it cleaned out all the way around this place though eventually. I think my log pile fell down. Let me see if I can get this one on. This thing don't really like to turn too sharp with the big load on it like that. Hauling them with this out there too, is stacking them, it works quite a bit better than one of the log trucks. Need to get over just a little bit more if we can. I want to stack them as tight as I can. Haul a couple more loads, then we'll put what we got out there in the mill. Well, I'm unloading them on the other side, but they're still... they're still in a good place. Let's go back and get one more, then we'll put them in. I think that should work. Alright, I'm gonna hop out and we'll go around here. And we got 4,011,230 in. Now we got 4,416,000. So that worked out pretty good. I think we're gonna wrap this one up, y'all. I appreciate y'all watching. Until next time, later, y'all.